As you know, I've videoed this many, many times. So, this is winter at Cheddar Gorge. Not a bleak midwinter, not really. No ice, no snow, no fierce wind. I'm not doing loads today. It's already changing, but of course up here it would be colder. But you can see all the flooding over there, right over there on the levels. Lots and lots of flooding. I'm just going to be... This part isn't so bad for walking because it's very grassy. It's not so slippery. It's when you get near the rocks and the mud. That's... Not many people out. Lovely blue sky though. God, I'm in Cheddar Gorge, everyone. I can't believe it. Can't believe it. Right over there, I've got my Crook's Peak. Right over there. I can't see a thing with the Sony because it hasn't got a viewfinder. It's really difficult to see anything. You have to guess, point and guess. There's a few couples around. There's one girl on her own walking a minute ago. I'm not going close to the edges. Not like I normally do. I might do one. I might do one here and maybe another one further down. I sometimes do. There is time, I think. I will start panicking when it's 1 o'clock, I think. Because it only gives me an hour and a half. And the tricky bit is further down. Not here. The tricky bit is further down. Yes, I'm glad I got out. I am so glad I got out, everyone. You know, it is quite nippy. I've just put my fingerless gloves on and I've put my hat back on. But you imagine it out here when that storm was blowing the other day. I can see goats scattered around. The Cheddar goats. Various people on the other side of the gorge as well, walking about. But you have got to be careful, it's slippery. January last year I broke my wrist falling over a curbstone, not because but I have slipped before when I've been out walking. I'm lucky I never broke anything in the past, to tell the truth. It's the way I fell before. It's the way I fell. Yes, very bleak at the moment. All the trees are fast asleep, except for the evergreens. But I've got out here, folks. A lifeline has been given to us. A lifeline. I'm making the most of it all. This is where you've got to be careful on these muddy bits. This is what slows me up, see, that's what I've got to take into account when I'm going further down in a minute. It's going to be very, very slippery. You'll be clinging to trees and things like that. So I won't be doing many of these excursions. Quite often you get goats out on these outcrops. In fact, there's a small goat, a couple of small goats there. They sit right on the edge. They really do. Sit right on the edge. It's like, you know, I've been given back my home in a strange sort of way. Because I'm surrounded by all my reference points that I love. You know, we've got Crook's Peak, Brent Knoll, Cheddar Gorge. We had the aerials, we had Roebourne Warren. We've got Glastonbury Tor, Nyland Mound. Wells Mast and all the fields and places I like to roam. But I'm just thinking, seeing those cows then, where I normally walk in the winter, I think they're putting harder cows out. Hardier. Whether they're going to bring them in, because we are apparently expecting much colder weather. So it hasn't come yet, not to us down here. normally around about now you'd have snow in that up here. Not anymore. See this little goat walking out on the outcrop there? Right, I think we're crossover, Sheila. Crossover onto a drier area. That's it. Look at that beautiful view. God, you know, I'm not staying out long today because mainly I think I'm being sensible. Because to be quite honest, 4 o'clock probably would have been okay. But if that bus is late, like someone said it was the other day, you imagine you've done a walk, you're cooling down, and you're having to wait for the bus. Now, this one could be late, but I don't think it tends to be late when it's they pick a lot of school kids up. Oh, this bus I'm getting on now, I'll have to get on with the school kids, I think. It might be packed. But anyway, this is a recce day. And not a brief visit. I mean, I would have been out here 3 or 4 hours. That's all you need for the gorge. I don't do the gorge all the time. I have to pass by the gorge a lot en route to my other walks. But I don't do the gorge constantly, if you know what I mean. And I often do that side. A lot of my walks, I would come back that way and go down through the wood. And I got other ways I come down through. Tutters Hill, I think you call it. Yeah, it's beautiful, isn't it? A beautiful day. I feel so lucky, so gifted to be able to be allowed out here again. Like the gods have looked down and said, Sheila, we're letting you have your freedom back. I had a camp out here for 2 or 3 nights. I only did 2 in the end because the weather was changing for the worse. I paid for 3 nights, but I only did 2. And that was just so I could get out. And I did the Velvet Bottom and the Black Rock, and I did all the way up there. I did a massive 8-hour walk that day to encompass as much of over here as I could. Don't forget, even when I was getting out to Roeborough okay, because the 1-2-5 bus, which I haven't used yet, it used to be number 10, or I can't remember, I had another number, 51 I think it was. I used to use that bus to get out to Roeborough. I still had that, but what happened there, those buses were very infrequent. So you really, really had to plan. And they were all, and I stopped doing it in the winter just because they weren't totally reliable. Right, just going to turn off for a bit, folks, take some pictures. Over and out. Right, over there we've got the goats sunbathing. Some of them are asleep, soaking up the sun. Some of the bigger ones further back. Yeah, they've got the eyes shut, really absorbing the sunlight. There used to be a big hotel there. They pulled it all down. It's all gone now. Great big hotel. Never thought they'd ever pull that down for some reason. It was an ancient inn, really. But it was prone to flooding all the time. What a beautiful scene this is, everyone. I've just got over an hour to get down to get my bus. Bus, if I miss this one, I've got to wait another hour and a half to 4 o'clock. But I'm enjoying this, and I'm not letting it worry me, but I've got to talk about the 126 because it's a godsend for me, to be quite honest. I'm not going to moan about it. I'm so grateful to it. I just got to put up with any inconveniences that there might be. Look at all this massive geology, everyone. absolutely gorgeous, and I'm going to be walking all over the place over this. It's on trial for 18 months. Let's hope they keep it. Oh, I hope so. Over now. Not far from the bottom now. High up here still, of course, but taking my time, gradually walking down. It's quite slippery and bumpy. There's the Snake Bend Road there. I've cycled down that and driven up it quite a few times. Some sort of cave entrance there. Goats all over the place. Yeah. Cheddar in the winter. So I won't be doing much more videoing now, everyone. I'm concentrating on safety. And getting back safely for the bus. But there's quite a bumpy bit down there, but I often do this little diversion round. I often do it. And you have a really great view here of all the gorge. Really great view. I'll just take another picture. Here. Oh, a minute. Am I still videoing? Yeah, this camera's playing up at the moment. They sometimes do in different weather. Yeah, it keeps taking the wrong picture. Oh, wait a minute. Doing something strange. Yeah, there's a delay. I don't know what that delay's about. No, it's not that. Let's turn it off a minute. I think I'm still videoing. Yeah, the camera. Something like a seal came out of it earlier. Like turning off.